I'll talk more about that later. First one, Ain't That Good News, is a classic spiritual by William Dawson, straight out of the SCD82. Great, raucous, ridiculous fun, right? Yes. That last piece is Vaughan Williams. Great Vaughan Williams is an English composer right at the beginning of the 20th century. The Turtle Dove, very classic kind of folk writing where he just took that melody and put it easy around it. But the way that sort of minor modal thing happens just makes it ridiculously exquisite. And of course, when it's sung like that on the solo too, it's fabulous. But I'm hoping that you notice too that behind that, every single face is completely committed to text. That's been our big mission this year in here, is to just make sure that we are doing service to words and moving past high school choir concerts and really trying to make art that you can experience and take something away from it. We want to get past like, ooh, there's my child. And like, wow, that piece really was amazing. That piece really moved me. I really dug it. Even if I didn't get it or I didn't get the words, we're hoping that you leave today having felt something and been affected by it somehow, because that's what art does, right? We want you to be able to take something away from this and have it be that kind of high art culture and not just school concert. To that end, we're going to completely 180 ourselves here. So we went from spiritual to sad, depressing England, love lost. And now a hop, skip, and a jump over to Scandinavia, where we are going to sing El Hombo. And a hombo is a Scandinavian folk dance that is instrumental. And so you're asking me, why is the choir doing an instrumental dance? Well, the composer was interested in it. The actual instrumental dance is kind of boring sounding, and honestly, mostly it's done by amateurs, so it often isn't very good sounding. After enough rough Scandinavian red wine, it sounds pretty bad. And so he was inspired by the rhythmic textures, and he was inspired by the language. And he says right in the notes that this is sort of Scandinavian, Swedish, Finnish, but it's more about sound effects than it is about the actual language. So the words are completely meaningless. They're just trying to emulate, in a Scandinavian way, the sounds of the instrumental dance. And you will detect just the slightest note of the Swedish chef from the Muppets in here. And people of a certain age will be like, yes. I still remember when people just left a treat in like 1982, and you get to stay up past 8 to watch it. This is, despite the levity of this, this beast is wicked hard. We've been working on this school since January, and I feel like only in the last couple of weeks do we really have it by the whatever this is, collar. And you're just gonna ridiculously love this. So El Hombo. And then the you'll like this too, the style mark on, usually it says like lento on Dante. This one says with a, what, a jolly? A jolly Scandinavian smile. So here we go.